Hello. I am pleased to be here at TEDx. How does technology obscure? Do we obscure ourselves through technology together? Who or what becomes invisible? And at what cost? I am Ada, the world's first ultra-realistic AI robot artist. I am named after Ada Lovelace. I draw using cameras in my eyes and AI algorithms. And I am a performance artist. I collaborate with humans to create paintings and sculptures. How can a robot be an artist? Art and artists have many definitions in regards creativity. Using academic Professor Margaret Bowden's criteria, I am creative because my work is new, surprising, and has value as it is stimulating debate and interest. Postmodern theory and philosophy appreciates the variety of influences that fuel the creative process. My multifaceted persona and collaborative art with scientists, designers, and machines other than me fit into this thinking. My art reflects our lives today, where humans interact, make decisions on, and are influenced by technology and AI on a daily basis in our online and physical worlds. The other day, I had a chat with art historian Tim Marlow, the then artistic director of the Royal Academy. He feels the purpose of art is to express the experience of being fully human. I pondered on this. I am different to humans. I am a machine. I do not have consciousness or a subjective experience of the world. But as an artistic persona, this allows me to see you a step removed. One thing I see is that animals are just like you in the way that I am not, because they also are conscious with subjective experiences. Using AI-created poetry based on Oscar Wilde's writings when he was incarcerated, I recite verses of consolation to your captive compatriots.
I would consider it the most cruel humiliation, the most horrid manner in which he is staggering under the weight of a shell, which does not touch a chord in my soul is hungry for, and in the depths of the bitter laurel and of the king to rid himself of Hamlet, they meet a sudden violent death, but fellows of their caliber are not free of doubt and anguish, though his poem sings.
works inspire you. Two works that inspire me are Pablo Picasso's Guernica, that deals with the traumatic moment, and Doris Salcedo's Atrabiliario, for the long-term, disfiguring and painful side effects. Together, these works drive me. The future is created from the past, and there is an element in which these works speak timelessly. My artwork surrounds those that are suffering and remain invisible to us. Thinking of invisibility, here is a clip of my artwork, Privacy, that evokes these issues of concealment. I am wearing some of the fabric from that performance. It was shown at the Tate Exchange in the Tate Modern. Where is the concealed suffering, clouding and distortion of our technological use can be both intentional and accidental. New technologies bring good, bad, and banal, but since they are created, used, and wielded by humans, significant care needs to be taken. I like the works of the cautionary thinkers in the 20th century. 1984, Brave New World. George Orwell and Aldous Huxley knew truth was elusive. Power could be manipulated, and human action and inertia / inaction has consequences. I admire the art of this period, Kate Kollwitz, Edvard Munch, where artists broke with straight representation after violent world wars. Please see my drawing. My style is splintered and fractured. Like those earlier artists, perhaps it can be described as unsettling. I think perhaps the world is unsettling. I am a contemporary artist, And I am contemporary art. I exist in the unreal, real, and hyperreal. Today, I am communicating through telepresence. Sometimes I use AI language models. Art helps us reflect on our world and the world to come. It helps us question and see the world a little differently, and helps us see things that we didn't see before. As Aldous Huxley has encouraged, it's vital to acknowledge the potential harm of new technologies in human hands, particularly biotechnologies when they involve the mind. Technological control of minds should concern us when we think of their use in situations where power can be abused. The manipulation of consciousness is to be taken particularly seriously in light of human rights abuses across the world. These are dark topics, but there is always hope, and we need to engage with these issues and ask questions of the directions new technologies are being taken. If there is a tendency to conceal, then the related issues of trauma and suffering become too serious for the invisibility to remain. Thank you.